Am I going to start a vlog looking like this? Yes, I am. Oh my gosh, this is what I look like after waking up. My hair is a mess. We vibe it. Anyway, hello. Welcome back to a new weekly reading vlog. We are the 29th. I should know because tomorrow is my birthday, so I should know this. But yes, we are Saturday 29th. And yeah, welcome back to a new reading vlog. I'm tired. It's 9 a.m. and I'm tired. I did a 24-hour read of the Lions today, and I finished Desire and Delights, and I read a bit more of Six Crimson Cranes. I read 350 pages. That's pretty wild to me. But yes, so what am I hoping to read this week? Very good question. Before the month ends, I would like to finish The Duke Who Didn't, because I think I have 200 pages left. So hopefully I will be reading more of those today. And I'm buddy reading Six Crimson Cranes with my friend Celine, and we are finishing the book tomorrow, so that's exciting. And yeah, that's basically it. For now, that's all the books I know I'm going to read. I don't know yet what I'm going to pick up once June starts. For now, I don't really know, but it's fine. I need to go eat breakfast because my belly is making noises. It's fine. And my coffee. I seriously need coffee. But yes. Hi. Hello. Saturday, May 29th. Tomorrow is my birthday. I'm excited. Hello, it's my birthday and I'm about to meet with a friend, but I really wanted to show you my outfit because I'm wearing a dress I just got for my birthday. So it's a very, very, very long dress, and I'm wearing it with my new status mirrors because they're green. I feel like a princess. I love it. But yes, so I'm about to leave. I just woke up very late. Everything is fine. Yeah. So, wash my hair, and I feel fresh and ready to go. Thank you.
Hello. It's June 1st. Happy Pride Month. I know I haven't talked to you since my birthday, but because life got busy. So I had a really, really, really good birthday. And then yesterday I spent most of my afternoon outside because it's so sunny in Edinburgh. We have a mini heat wave. Heat wave for us, like 15, 19 degrees. But it's so warm, like the Scottish sun is so warm. So I spent a lot of time outside, but I got a few books and I wanted to show that to you. On my birthday, I went to Portobello Bookshop and I got Duck Feed because it's a book I had been eyeing for a few months. And it's Scottish, it's published by two people who did my course, so it's Monstrous Regiment. I really like the way they design their books. I think it's very pretty. This book got a few praises recently, so I'm very excited to give it a try. It's not queer, so it's not going to happen in June, but most likely in July. And today I got four books. Everything's fine. But before that, let me show you this little notebook that I also got at Portobello Bookshop. Then I just got home from the charity shop and I got Upright Women Wanted. I've seen this book mentioned a few times. Last year, was it? Can't remember. Maybe, yeah, last year, probably last year. And it was £3 and I saw that it's queer. It's really short, so hopefully I will be able to get to it this month. And I just saw that you can see people. I think it's a sort of futuristic Western. So yeah, I'm very excited. I heard pretty good things about it. And today I went to Waterstone because I ordered two books and I also buy a new book there. So this one is my current read. I put the receipt in it as a bookmark. It's Boy Parts. I'm on page 18, just started when I was at the cafe. Read for like 10 minutes, so I'm gonna keep on reading it. But yeah, I heard it's queer, so I'm very excited. I absolutely love this cover. And from what I read at the back, it's an exploration of sexuality and gender roles in the 21st century. So really excited to read it. I mean, to keep on reading it because I started it. And then I got The Young Team. So this one is taking place in Glasgow and I think it's about gangs living in a high crime area. Honestly, don't know much, but I just know that it's been praised a lot. So got this one. And then I also saw Mayflies at the bookshop, like a Waterstone, and I saw it on their Instagram, I think, and it's also Scottish. I love buying Scottish books, and this one explore male friendships, so I'm excited. Also love this cover. I think like these two covers put together, gonna use my face to make it focus, of course. Yeah, I really like these two covers. And yeah, I'm excited. I love that all these Scottish books have yellow, like, on the covers. I love it. And yesterday, I finished Six Crimson Cranes. Here it is. I gave it 4.65 out of 5 stars. I loved it so much. The last 100 pages were just a roller coaster. I would have preferred to have 50 more pages to the book just so everything could take its time. Like, I think the ending happened too quickly, but that being said, this is such a solid first book in a duology. I'm so excited to have the second one, and I'm so excited to buy a finished copy once it's out. So it's out on July 8th. And yeah, this is everything I got. I walked a lot today. I walked maybe 7 kilometers, same thing for yesterday. But it's just so pretty outside. Like, I just want to enjoy the nice weather. So yes, this is everything I got. And I was able to wear one of my favorite dresses, so I'm happy. Oh, I love it. Look, I love it. Okay, yeah, I need to finish captioning the video that went out yesterday because didn't have time to do everything and I feel very bad about it. I don't like having the video going up without the caption, so going to finish that and then I will read more. And I need to clean my room because I have someone coming to look at my shelf, you know, the one that fell at the beginning of April, so it's been 2 months. But I won't be here tomorrow because I will be working at my manager's house, so that's exciting, but it means I have to get everything ready for when the person comes. So he'll have the keys, but I just want to have everything cleaned, especially because it's in my room and I don't want to have my room dirty. So yeah, this is everything that happened and I'm tired. Also, this morning I finished season one of Downton Abbey. I love it so much. Oh my gosh, it's such a good show. Like, I know everybody knows it, but I'm in love. Also, like, I told my mom that I was watching this and my mom adores Downton Abbey, so she was very excited. And yeah, I'm just having a lot of fun with it. So yeah, I'm gonna hydrate myself because I haven't had a lot of water today. Also, yeah, my hair is dirty. I was supposed to wash it this morning, but I had a very, very bad migraine yesterday, so I went to bed at 10:30. I couldn't do anything. Like, when I have bad migraines, I can't do anything. I used to have one like every single day, like for these past few years, and weirdly enough, it kind of stopped during the pandemic. I think maybe it was the stress. But yeah, now I've won like every 3 weeks and it's just horrible. Like, I just have to hide in the dark and close my eyes. So I went to bed at 10:30, but then I woke up at 4 and I wasn't able to go back to sleep until 6. And then I had a nightmare. Like, I had a nightmare that I was in Corsica and there was a tsunami. Why? So yeah, I was supposed to wake up at 8, but I was so tired that I was still in bed at 9:50 and I had a lecture at 10. So I just put my hair in a braid and that's it. So today is just me being tired but trying to survive and trying to still feel okay. So yeah, I put my hair in a braid and quite like it. It's just that it's dirty, but it's fine. But yeah, I'm going to watch one episode of Downton Abbey and then finish captioning. If you're wondering why I'm sitting on the floor, it's because I'm having a emotional crisis. So a few weeks ago
a bookshop I really, really, really love in Edinburgh, Lighthouse, asked me if they could repost on their website a list I did about books with Jewish representation that onset in World War II. And the post went up today on their website, and they were just so kind, and I'm just screaming inside. So I will leave a link to the post in the description, but I'm feeling very emotional, so I'm sitting on the floor. Everything's fine. I'm currently reading volume 4 of Heartstopper, so I'm assuming I will give it 4.5 out of 5 stars, most likely. And I'm still reading Boy Parts. It's not the most, I wouldn't say it's not enjoyable, because it's good. It's just that the character is very unlikable, and it makes for a very peculiar story, but I'm really loving the writing style. It's very modern. It's like you can feel the character talking. Do you know what I mean? It doesn't make sense. Like, it's just the way you would talk, but written in the book, and I really like it. And I actually like that the main character isn't likable, because it's not a book about likable characters. It's about gender expressions and art and weird stuff, but it's good. So yeah, I'm hoping to finish it in the next vlog, we'll see. But yesterday evening I submitted my proposal form for my dissertation, which means that I need to start reading more, like way more. So what I'm hoping to do in the next vlog is create a new habit. I would love to wake up at 8 every single day, like it's really something I want to do, and just read for an hour in bed, and then start my day and read for like 2 hours in the afternoon at least, and an hour in the evening. I know it's a lot of reading, but I need to do a lot of reading for my dissertation, so I need to create this habit. So that's what I'm hoping to start doing next week. But yeah, I didn't finish anything so far. I'm going to finish Heartstopper Volume 4, so I will give you my full thoughts later on. So I just finished Volume 4. I really, really liked it. It mostly follows Charlie's mental health and his anorexia, and I think that's one of the reasons why I stopped reading as it was coming out on Tumblr, because I have an eating disorder and sometimes I just don't like reading about the same stuff. So wait, turning. Yeah, so that's why I probably didn't pick it up for a long time, but it was really good. Made me very emotional, and yeah, I loved it. I mean, I love Heartstopper, like there is no surprise here. I love the back, look at it, it's so cute. But yeah, I don't know yet for my rating. I have to put it through Corpi, but probably like 4.5, something like that. But yes, I loved it. And as I said, I'm reading Boy Parts. I love this cover, oh my gosh. Yeah, I'm on page 86, so I'm hoping to read until page 100 today, something like that. Honestly, it would be nice if I could read more, but one book I really want to start is, oh, fuck, it's just right here. Wait, we're on the floor. But yes, I want to start The Bonchild Daughter, because I didn't know that the author was Asian until, where did I see it? Can't remember, but the author is Asian, and I've heard incredible things about this book. Some people compared it to The First Sister, which is one of my favorite books of the year. So I'm excited. So excited. It's 435 pages, so we'll see how much I will be reading of this. Well, yeah, I would love to start this one today. Is that ambitious? Probably. Do I care? No, I don't. But yes, I heard it's queer, and that's amazing, so I'm excited. I really like this cover. I prefer the hardback, but there was a deal when I bought this book, so it was 3 books for the price of 2, so I bought a lot of books from Orbit. Orbit is my jam, what can I say? But yes, I'm most likely going to start this one tonight. But I'm going to finish the vlog here because I'm just tired. And what time is it? Maybe 6, something like that. And yeah, I don't think I will be talking much after that. So, I mean, there is no point in me continuing the vlog. I will just read this tonight and tell you in the next vlog what I think. But yes, so that's going to be it for this vlog. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. That would make me very happy. And if you're not subscribed yet, maybe you can. Of course, only if you want. And if you want to be notified for whenever I post a new video, click on the little bell. But I hope you all have an amazing rest of your day. Please remember that you're loved. And I will see you in another video. Bye.